friends, I'm Walker and welcome back to All About Nails, where we talk about vegan and cruelty-free nail polish. Today, I'm going to be doing a Paint My Nails With Me video. I did this series during Nailmas and Vlogmas, and I focused each week on a different month's Topic Tuesday prompts. And so today I'm going to do one of those again. Today we're going to be talking about June 2018 prompts, and I'm really excited. My manicure today is going to be this gorgeous neutral shade. This is Normani. This is from the first Naturel collection, and I'm actually working on a throwback review of this collection because it has so many beautiful neutral nude shades, but Normani is the one that when I put it on to swatch, I just wanted to keep it out and wear it as a full manicure. So that's what we're gonna do today. And I already have my base coat on. This is the Orly Nail Defense Strengthener. This works super well. I have really enjoyed seeing how strong my nails get using this. I have way less peeling than I did before I started using this. This is linked down below in the description. You can buy it on Amazon. I buy mine at CVS, so you can buy it all over the place. And then I will top it off with the Naked Manicure Glossy Seal. I like this top coat. You can see it's like almost empty. It's about like maybe a third full still. And so I do need to get some more of this and also some more of the Pacifica top coat that I really, really like. But right now I'm using the Glossy Seal until it runs out. So I already have the strengthener on. I really like it. I think it works really, really well. The only problem that I've found is that if I don't let it dry like 100%, it will make my manicure just not last as long. It makes it so that the polish doesn't really adhere to the nail as well. So I usually put the strengthener on, you know, and then kind of assemble all the products for my manicure and just give it a couple extra minutes to dry, more than I would a typical base coat. I don't really mind that extra drying time now that I'm used to it, but just a thing to be aware of if you're considering using that product. What I really like about it is that it's vegan. A lot of those strengtheners are not vegan, and so I really like that this one is vegan and cruelty-free, and for me at least, works really well. Okay, so we are doing June 2018 Topic Tuesday prompts, and I do think that I answered some of these on Instagram because at this point in the year last year, I was kind of following along. But the first question is the last polish that I purchased. I have been on a really low buy. So actually the last polish that I purchased that I have with me right now are the Winter Hollows from Zoya. So Cadence and Everly I got like at the end of December. Everly is the more reddish one here and Cadence is the more pink one. And I did a live swatch and review of these that I'll link up above if you haven't seen it yet. But those were the last polishes that I purchased. And the next question is really easy to answer too. It's my favorite bottle shape for polish. And I think this is such an interesting question. I probably hadn't put much thought into this question for a while because most of my collection was Zoya, and so I really liked Zoya because I could store them, you know, all together and they work together really well. But I will say, I think my favorite shape for polish are more square bottles. So I really like the Kale Polish, and I'll grab one in just a second. And I really like the Quixotic Polish bottles. They're just like these really nice, tall, square on the bottom, but rectangular going up, if that makes sense. So here's a Kale Polish bottle. It's like the bottom is a square, but it's tall, so it's not like, you know, the square hue bottles that used to be like short and actually like a cube. Here is a Quixotic Polish bottle. I really like, I think it's very similar to the Kale Polish bottle, and I really like it. I think they store super easily. They're so easy to store. I will say I also like the Society Wit bottles. They're the like super thin ones. These hold the same amount of polish, but you can store so many of them just next to each other in a drawer because they're so thin, so you can really fit a lot in there, which is really nice. So I guess when it comes to bottle shape, I'm more concerned about how they store. I don't love the Orly bottles. They're just so much negative space when you store them because they don't really fit next to each other flush, and they just take up so much space to try and store those ones. Like a, you know, two collections of Orly is like 12 polishes, and I could fit like 20 Zoyas in that space. So I really like the square bottoms that just fit together a little bit nicer. Zoya's bottle, I think, is really pretty, and they store fine for me if I just store them all next to each other, but I will say that the square bottle is my favorite. I'm curious how many people have, like, really strong opinions about this, so if you do have a strong opinion, let me know. All right, and as always, I'm painting my thumbs off screen because I can do a lot of things, but I cannot paint my thumbs while I'm filming. It is really, really hard. Okay, so those were two. There were four prompts in June, which means there were four Tuesdays in June. And the next prompt is one that I had to think about a lot. I don't know. I feel like these, like, top one polishes are really hard for me. This one is your favorite all occasion slash go-to polish. I don't know. I really like a very soft, like, neutral, you know, quote unquote work appropriate polish. I think they are really pretty to wear. They're really satisfying to wear. And so I tend to wear a lot of neutrals. Not necessarily because I can't wear other colors in my work environment, but just because I really like them. They make me feel classy and put together. I would say, though, I don't know that I have one favorite because I do like to wear them so often. So I had to pick a couple, and the couple that I thought of were Carson, which came out in the Jubilee collection last year, and I really love this one. It's perfect for the winter because it's really like pigmented. It's not super washed out. I do like colors like Brigitte and Rue for, like, springtime, maybe. They're a little bit more kind of muted purple, whereas Carson is just, like, a really warm nude. But I also really like more, like, taupey colors. I really like Noah. There are so many nudes that I love. Kale Polish also has some really nice nudes, so I don't know. I find it really hard to pick a go-to. I know that Rue is one that a lot of people really, really like for an all-occasion polish. That one, for me, is a little bit, I don't know, it's a little bit too muted. I tend to want something with a little bit more color. So I like Rue, but if I'm gonna go for, like, a muted mauve, I'm actually gonna probably pick Brigitte or maybe Mia or Piper. Those ones are a little bit more, like, pigmented blush colors. Rue is one that people go for a lot. Brighton is also a really nice one if you pick that up in the Winter Trio because it's neutral but has a little bit of sparkle, which I know a lot of people really like. They like to have a little bit of sparkle. So anyways, that is to say, I don't know that I have one all-occasion polish, but there are a lot of really nice ones out there. All right, the last prompt is your favorite nail care items. And I don't necessarily know what the definition of nail care is. There's, like, so many things that could fit in that category. So I think I'm defining this as, like, anything I use to take care of my nails and cuticles. And I think the first thing that I would say is my glass nail file. And I bought a 3-pack on Amazon that all came together, and they come in 3 different sizes. So I have this big one that I keep at my nail desk, and then I have had a medium size. The medium size actually broke. I, like, dropped it on the ground and then rolled my chair over it on accident. And then my small one I keep in my bag that I bring to work. So I have it with me if I have, like, a snag when I'm at work. I love my glass nail file. It's the 3 that I bought are linked down below in my description. And then I've already talked about my strengthener. I think between the strengthener and the nail file, that's really how I get my nails to have a shape that I like. It's how I get my nails to, like, not break really, really deep breaks. You know, I get, like, small corner breaks, but I don't get, like, massive breaks because I try and file away. Anytime I have a little snag on the end of my nail, I file it away so that it can't get caught on anything. And being able to have that really small one with me at work means that I can really do that anywhere that it happens. I don't have to, like, wait till I get home, which is really nice. And then as far as, like, cuticle care, hydration stuff goes, I think these are the two products that I've been using the most this winter. This is the Orly Cuticle Therapy Cream, and this came in the winter collection Color Pass box from Orly, and I have been obsessed with it. I have used so much. It's huge, but let's see how much I use. Yeah, there's, like, a lot missing in there. I use this when I'm swatching because, you know, the acetone that I use really dries out my nails, but this gets them really well hydrated and makes it so that after I'm done swatching a bunch of polishes, my nails don't look crazy, my cuticles don't look crazy dry. And then recently I've been using the Bliss Kiss, just their regular jojoba oil pens. And I have to say, I'm really impressed with these. They are a little bit on the expensive side. Like this one, I just feel like I haven't used that many times and it's almost gone. Maybe I'm using too much, but it's working really well for my nails. So I know that they sell like refillable pens on Amazon. You can buy jojoba oil. So I'm gonna try and make some of these my own and see if I can get them for less than the Bliss Kiss. But I will say I've noticed a big difference between this and other oils that I've used. Specifically, I've bought one from CVS before that was okay. This one definitely is noticeably better at keeping my cuticles super hydrated, keeping my nails super hydrated, but I don't know, we'll see. I don't know that I can justify shelling out the money for it. The cuticle therapy cream, because it comes with so much, is worth the money. I'm so impressed by this. I will say I still see this like in my CVS and other places with a formula that's not vegan. This one is vegan. This is the large size. They have a smaller size as well. And they, when I emailed Orly about the recipe on this, they told me that the smaller size was being replaced. All of the larger ones apparently should be vegan by now, but all of the smaller ones are in the process of being replaced. I think they're just like going through back stock, but they said the recipe on this is now vegan and will be vegan forever. So if you are looking for one of these, just look for the ingredient lanolin. That's the ingredient that was in here previously that is not vegan. But now it doesn't have lanolin in it. So just keep your eyes out if you're looking for that product. If you have any cuticle hydration products that you swear by, I would love, love, love to hear them because especially in the winter, I am just like absolutely in need of them. It is so hard to keep my hands and my cuticles moisturized in the winter. A thing that I'm trying to experiment with that I haven't really figured out yet is like exfoliating my hands, doing like a sugar scrub, but no results yet. I'm still kind of experimenting with that. I will say that the Bliss Kiss has made a big difference on my nails and also just like doing it really consistently, I probably moisturize like 4 or 5 times a day, which sounds like a lot, but I love it. Oh, okay. I have a little spot on my pinky that I hit on my tripod. That is the danger of doing my manicure on camera, is that there's all this equipment in the way and you get to see every flaw. So I'm like really invested in finding really good cuticle moisturizers, hand moisturizers right now. What I really like about the jojoba oil is that it just kind of rubs in really quickly, like the My Bliss Kiss. It doesn't stay oily for a long time, which is really nice. I got the unscented one, so it just smells like nothing, which is also nice. All right, cool. Real time, that was 18 minutes, which is not bad for a manicure. I mean, I guess add maybe 2 minutes because I did do my base coat previously. I did a little bit of filing, but 18 minutes for a manicure, not bad. And I stopped to show you some fun products. So I think I like timing myself like this. It's really interesting to see how long this takes because I think a lot of people in my kind of day-to-day life say, oh, I don't have time to do my nails, I don't have time, but it's totally a habit that I don't think takes that much time once you kind of get the process down and you have really high quality materials. Awesome, so let me know down below what your favorite bottle shape is and what your favorite cuticle nail care items are because I'm always on the lookout for some new products. And if you have tried any of the products that I mentioned, let me know. I would love to hear your thoughts on them. And as always, thank you so much for hanging out with me to talk about nail polish. I cannot wait to see you in the next one. Bye!